Hello, yes, it is the Snoo Wolf. I really hope to God you can't hear the dishwasher in the background. You shouldn't, because I have the mic on the one-way thing, but it's loud. And I can't unplug my headphones to fucking check the audio levels, because for some reason when I do that, Streamlabs is just like, oh, you don't have headphones in? Sound doesn't fucking exist. So let me just go ahead and check with my Bluetooth headphones really quick. Oh. Or the stream can just start buffering on my phone. That's fine. That's great. I love this. This is a fantastic start to the stream. Become violent, because now the stream is like a whole fucking minute behind on my phone. Very levels. I hate that my fucking phone just sometimes decides, sorry, internet isn't fucking real, and just doesn't want to cooperate with anything. Twitch says plain art. Yeah, man. Okay, this is fine. I'm gonna just turn off fucking Wi-Fi, you piece of shit. Maybe it'll work then. I think the music is a little too quiet. I also just really can't fucking tell if you can hear the goddamn dishwasher. That's what I'm most concerned about. I can't just fucking plug in my goddamn headphones, because then I can't hear the audio. I hate this fucking phone. Come on, you piece of shit, you gonna fucking cooperate or do I have to fucking throw you in the trash? It's fucking... Why? I'm so tempted to just start fucking slamming it on my desk to see if that'll make it fucking work. I just need to check my fucking... You know what? Fine. Fuck you. Fuck you. You win. I'm not fucking bothering anymore. God damn it. New has internet problems pretending it's on the street. It's not even internet problems, it's literally just my fucking phone. Like, for some reason, it keeps buffering every, like, second with the fucking stupid-ass Wi-Fi. As soon as I was using my goddamn headphones to listen to it, it's suddenly fucking buffering all the goddamn time. I hate this piece of shit. Because Mox and I got new fucking phones, and we got, like, these 5G ones, and boy, is that a fucking jip. Anyway, art time. We drawing my boy. We drawing my boy, because I've been thinking about him all day. I'm gonna have a D&D session where I'm playing this motherfucker later, and... Thank you, medic. Yeah, no, fucking... I have been dreading the session I'll be playing later tonight for about a month. Because we had a 2-week hiatus, and then last week we were going to play, and then had to cancel at the last minute because the DM, didn't get off work early enough. So we wouldn't have had time to play at all. But tonight, as far as I can tell, it all things are go. So to sum up most of it, Monster Girls. A harem of Monster Girls. And this stupid ass motherfucker is in the middle of all of it. The unfortunate bastard. I need to find an easy closer thing. There it is. So I had this model set up like a long time ago. How long ago was this? January. I started this in January, and I haven't worked on it in a while. But it's when Toon got a hug from a pretty girl, and he didn't know what to do. His clothes were scary. Oh, I fucking have it right there. Shit. Yeah, pretty girl. I need to find her reference sheet really quick. Is. That's right, I was using this in the reference window and then just having this on the side. So I always do that. This poor, stupid, socially inept boy doesn't know how to handle getting a hug from a girl. I think about it. I don't remember what his coat looked like. That is... There's a scar on the sheet. Okay. I just noticed the video game thing on the top. Weren't you the one that... No, that was someone else. Fucking, yeah, the, no, that's been there since I've had the new layout. Video game. Because sometimes I play video game on the screen. Not all the time, but sometimes. That ass, though. A fucking... Which one? Listen, she's a trauma victim. Next time I called my voicemail. I'm sure I'm just picking up my phone. Art time. Hello, girly. No, I haven't done art in a while. I'm drawing this one piece that I guess I started in fucking January of a tomb getting a hug from a girl. He's socially inept and doesn't know how to deal with that. I am having a lot of trouble with his hand angle for his right hand. I might just change it. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna change it. I don't like it. No, I don't like that one. I might just need to change the whole last arm angle. That doesn't work either. Mm-hmm. Hello, my wolf. Oh, good. I minimized Streamlabs and everything minimized. Hello. On the boy, this boy. This guy, he's stupid. Oh shit. In the motherfucking laundry. Should be done by now. Yeah, it's definitely done. Okay, yeah, I forgot to mention it. I did load in some laundry into the washer and stuff, so I'm going to be doing, BRBs a couple of times. Because I have to change the stuff over to the dryer, and then I have to bring it back. So I will be back in like 5-ish minutes. I have returned. Fuck. I dropped my phone.
Thank you.
I wrote that. I gotta piss.
What happened to the chatbot? Chatbots.
So I don't know what the fuck that was about. Chatbox just wasn't working for a second. It's working now, so Not good. I was about to draw Toon's normal shoes, and then I realized, no, he wouldn't be wearing normal shoes. He wears his fucking rocket boots literally everywhere he goes. And I've never designed them. Yes. Fuck. Yes. Fuck, it didn't work again. Can't share this picture. There we go. There they are. That's what they look like, sure. See, now the question I have to ask myself is, do they go over his pants, or do his pants go over the boots? And realistically, I'm pretty sure the boots go over his pants. Because otherwise he might light his fucking pants on fire like an idiot. Oh fuck, I still need to fucking level him up. Fuck. He's level fucking 11 now and he has one level on Artificer and I still haven't fucking leveled him up. Oh shit, fuck. How could I be so fucking foolish? Pausing the goddamn stream for art. Is this him? Yeah, there he is. Alright, fucking let's learn how to put a level of Artificer on this bitch. Fucking... My sheet is physical, so I can't really show it on stream, but what I can do... I can just do this. So, fucking... Oh god. Oh. Oh fuck. You need ability score for requisites to multi-class? I'm pretty sure Toons has it. But still. Must have at least an intelligence score of 13. He has a 16, so that's fine. Oh, it says it right there. Fuck, I'm stupid. We're gonna have to pass in or out of this class. That's weird. His hit die is the same as Rogue's. This was 11d8, thank god. Proficiency with thieves' tools? I mean, I guess that makes sense. Firearm proficiency technically already has that. Oh, he can get. Well, I've never actually multi-classed a character before. So I'm not sure if he just gets the. Beginning class features. Let's go proficiency to get from multi class and artificer. Let's start out with rogue, the level 3, and go into artificer after action. Okay, no skill proficiency is playing multi class and artificer. Okay, so I might just have to talk to DM. About this. Okay, per the Artificer class description on page 54 of Eberron Rising from the Lost War, or in Appendix D of Wayfinder's Guide to Eberron, is an optional rule addendum on how multiclassing an Artificer works if you're using the multiclassing rules. If your group uses the optional rule on multiclassing, Player's Handbook, page 163, here's what you need to know if you choose Artificer as one of your classes. Ability score minimum, you need to have at least an intelligence score of 13 to take a level in this class, or take a level in another class if you're already an Artificer. Proficiencies gained. If Artificer isn't your initial class, but the proficiencies you gain when you first level as an Artificer. Light armor, medium armor, shields, thieves' tools, tinker's tools.
Okay. Tim already has light armor proficiency. So I guess he gains medium armor and shield proficiency.
The wording on this is really fucking confusing to me. Spell slots. Add half your levels rounded up in the Artificer class to appropriate levels from the other classes to determine your available spell slots. I'm not sure what that means entirely. So would he have more spells than just the first level? I don't understand how this wording works. God, it hurts being stupid. Good features for that level. You don't have a received cost of starting event, and a few features have additional ability to hold the extra attack. Okay, you're a spellcaster. Capacity for spellcasting depends partly on your combined levels in all your spellcasting classes and partly on your individual levels in those classes. So, if you were a single class member of that class, you're a ranger of 4, wizard 3, for example, you know 3 first level ranger spells based on your levels in the ranger class. As a third level wizard, you know 3 wizard cantrips, and your spellbook contains 10 wizard spells, 2 of which, the 2 begin when you reach third level as a wizard, can be second level spells. Okay, so intelligence is 16, can prepare 6 wizard spells from your spellbook. Each spell you know and prepare is associated with one of your classes, and you use the spellcasting ability of that class when you cast the spell. Similarly, a spellcasting focus such as a holy symbol can be used only for spells from the class associated with that focus. Spell slots. Determine your available spell slots by adding together all your levels in magic classes, and half of your levels rounded down in paladin and ranger classes. Then that would mean that the only spells he knows, since he's just a mastermind rogue, he doesn't have spellcasting already. He only gets spells from the Artificer's Guild.
I'm wondering if it might be better, considering we have very heavy homebrew, if instead of multi-classing, I just stick to being full rogue. Oh, yum. Fucking. First level, you learn how to invest broken magic in one nail. You have this ability, you must have thief tools or artisan tools in hand. Timer, full object. You can give one of the following magical properties from your choice. Red light effect for radius and dim light for an extra 5 feet. Whenever tapped by a creature, the object emits a recorded message that can be heard up to 10 feet away. You utter the message and you bestow this property on the object, and the recording can be no more than 6 seconds long. Object continuously emits your choice of an odor or nonverbal sound, wind, waves, chirping, and the like. The chosen phenomenon is perceivable up to 10 feet away. A static visual effect appears on the object's surface. It can be a picture, up to 25 words of text, lines and shapes, or a mixture of these elements as you like. The chosen property lasts indefinitely. As an action, you can touch the object and end the property early. Don't be appear to casting spells unconventionally, you appear to produce wonders from mundane items and outlandish inventions. Use your artificer spell effects through tools, you must have a spell casting focus specific to thieves' tools or some kind of artisan tools in hand. You can cast any spell with a spell casting feature. You must be proficient with the tool to use it this way. See the equipment chapter in the player's handbook for descriptions of these tools. Two cantrips of your choice from the artificer spell list. At higher levels, you learn additional artificer cantrips of your choice. Are shown in the cantrips known column of your artificer table. You gain a level in this class by placing the artificer cantrips you know. Brain casting spells. Artificer table shows how many spell slots you have to cast your artificer spells. Cast one of your artificer spells at first level or higher. You must expend a slot of the spell's level or higher. Rest. Prior to the list of artificer spells that are available, you cast choosing from your spell list, and you so choose a number of artificer spells equal to your intelligence modifier plus half your artificer level. Rounded down, minimum of one spell. The spells must be for a level with which you have spell slots. Fifth level, artificer 4, first level, 2, 7, 14. The list of first spells can include 4 spells of first or second level in any combination. For the first level spell to your wound, you can cast using you prepare spells similar to a wizard. And for this spell, the first time spent tinkering with your spellcasting focuses at least 1 minute per spell level for each spell on your list. Okay. Intelligence is your spellcasting ability, makes sense. And you cast an artificer spell as a ritual. So It's like, I can just do this, or alternatively. I can just take my 11th level in Rogue. Which gives me reliable talent. And also my sneak attack is a bonus. Because instead of being a level 1 spellcaster, a level 10 rogue, I can instead just be a level 11 rogue, get two very good bonus things at this level. Tribal talents are fucking useful. And just because it's like the useful things when it comes to Artificer, I'm not going to be able to get to until third level in Artificer, which is Artificer Specialist. And it would be the Battlesmith, I believe, is what I would have gone with. So that's the one that lets me it's the one with the Steel Defender. Yeah, because of the way that we homebrew a lot of stuff, it costs to time, resources, and money to make his shit. It might just be better to just stay as a full rogue. So I think I might do that. I might just melt more people in this. I do, however, need to roll his fucking health up. Let's see, am I feeling lucky? Fucking the d8, and he has a plus 2 con, I should just take the plus 7, I probably shouldn't roll. Yeah, I'll just take the plus 7 to health, so now he has an even 80 health. I like to keep track of my character's health and stuff with index cards so I'm not fucking up this character sheet by constantly erasing and writing. I know I put them in here. I put fucking everything in here. Your health go. fucking... That's shit that Q has. That's important. Yeah. She didn't really. She had a fucking vial of 300 gold worth of diamond dust. Tomb! Where'd your fucking health go, dude? In the papers. I did not spot it. All I'm seeing is Charlotte's. These are Charlotte cards. Where the fuck is Tom? Delta's fucking thing again. So I wouldn't keep fucking losing it. God damn it. Stupid ass fucking headphones. Okay, well, whatever. Put that back on our time, because I don't need those. What the fuck is your health, you stupid shit? Also has his money. So it has his fucking money. It has his fucking health. It has a thing to keep track of how much damage his mask takes. So if that thing fucking breaks, he's absolutely boned. It has the goddamn bot's power supply. Tab, I guess. For some reason, it was in the Rainbow Legends player tab, not the MR players tab. But oh well, we found it. Crisis averted, y'all. his HP from 73 to 80. Officer, and change it to Rogue 11, class 11. This is sneak attack. 66. That's a reliable talent. Which means that if he rolls less than a 10, anything he's proficient in, it counts as a 10. An ability check that lets you add your proficiency bonus, you can treat a d20 roll as of a 9 or lower as a 10. Gonna need to clarify with Sky on if that applies to fumbles as well, because some DMs do that, some DMs don't. So basically, Toom has a minimum he can hit with the skills he's proficient in. So his deception, for example, which he has proficiency and expertise in specifically, the lowest roll he can get with that is an 18. Unless Sky rules that fumbles still happen. Ooh. That said, though, laundry is done. I need to go get it. So I'm just gonna put up the POV screen and go get laundry. And we'll be back in 5-ish minutes. And then when I get back, I'm gonna continue drawing for like an hour and then cluster. Because 7, I still need to eat, and there's more dishes I need to get done before D&D, which should be at 8. Hopefully. I'll be right back. We'll be right back.
Thank you.